Hello, folks. I'm back again, and I'm here in Barcelona with Jaume Mestres and Magda Solé. And they both have an institute for transpersonal psychology here in Barcelona. And they have an organization, it's called Hollows Travel. And they do journeys around the world for many years now to visit traditional cultures and shamans. This year they have a journey to Mexico, for example, and another one to the Baikal Sea. Yeah, and I'm here to just have a little chat about these topics. And Magda is a professor at the University of Barcelona for more than 25 years now.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Wonderful. Here they are. Nice to meet you. And
thank you.
Fine that you have found you. The time on the Easter holiday, just before the lunch. Okay. Yeah. What can you say? Maybe for you at first, the question: how is it that this correlation came between the psychology stuff and these journeys, and how do you bring this together? Can you say something on this? But your intention is there.
Yes, the intention is to share with students the way of working of shamans. Mm-hmm. Shamans know a very important knowledge about health and illness, and it's very interesting that Western people know them. No.
Yes. It's you mean it's interesting for them to get knowledge of these things that are
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Hmm. What is your idea? Maybe also as a researcher, what can the benefit be for a modern Western person in this field of this archaic traditions, and what can
first of all, sorry for my English.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
And
sorry for my Spanish.
Yes, because they include the spiritual dimension in the treatment in the way of heal. And that is of healing. That is very important because Western medicine have not at all this dimension.
They forgot it somehow on the way. Yeah. And the journeys you make, they are just for self experiences, or is it also combined with your with your study and your working?
Yes, always combined.
It's always combined.
Always combined. You have to combine because
because
we have two knowledge, very important knowledge. It's not only the shamanic knowledge. You have to combine.
Yes. Okay, what is your view on this exciting journeys?
Yes, my view is that an experience is the most deepest way to learn about life. Mm-hmm. Then our journeys has the characteristic that we always integrate experience, and then we do it integration with the group. Mm-hmm. Living with the group, mm-hmm. also the experience become more height, mm-hmm. more powerful.
Yeah.
Then it's amazing because we are preparing trips to different parts of the world, mm-hmm. looking for shamans. Now, for example, we are in preparing a trip to Sumatra, Indonesia, mm-hmm. to different tribes. They exist there, and then. We are investigating in university. We have very much students always interesting about healing, mm-hmm. about the spiritual healing. And then we think about that kind of trips, it's a very good a tool to experiment and to learn about life.
What I sometimes found difficult in this context is that people make, Western people make experience in these cultures, and then there were difficulties of integration these experiences. And also because integration, I would not say is half of the process, but it's a very important aspect of the process. And if you don't, were not able to integrate afterwards, or maybe also also in the process not able to integrate, I think the worst is questionable how how the value is of the experience. And for in this case, I find it really interesting that you go there as Western people, also Western scientists, and have your experiences made on your own, and that you are able to assist people, as far as I understand it, from the Western culture in this context, when normally there's not an not a possibility. Many shamans don't speak the same language as the people which are traveling there. I had the same problems in South America as well, and so it's very helpful, I guess, that you are there when you do this. Huh?
We think it's very important, because integration is mostly the most important part.
Yeah.
If not, you can live an experience alone or with others, but I integrating, you understand you all the thing that happens with you, and also you are in a safety place with experts and taking care of you during all the journey.
Yes.
That's we are doing, I think, in every detail. Magda is an expert integrating, asking, taking care both with all the groups.
Yes.
Because things happen during the trip and after the trip. And we are creating trips that things happen and important things for you.
Yeah, wonderful, yeah. Can you say something about maybe what is the difference between the different, is there a difference between the different cultures from the quality of the journey? Can you say that? If you travel to this continent or that continent, because all the shamanic cultures have a the core is always, I would say, the same in the deep.
Yes.
But on the when you, the further you come up, the more differences you find. And yeah, how do you see that?
Yes, the difference. Magda can explain.
But for example, in Baikal area, in Siberia, we can find a syncretism with shamanism and Buddhism. And it's very interesting. It was was the origin of shamanism. Then there the shamans are real shamans. they named himself shamans. For example, in Mexico, the syncretisms is between shamanism and Catholic
Christianity.
Christianity. Yeah. But they know named themselves shamans.
Shamans.
They are healers.
Yeah.
No, curanderos.
Curanderos.
In Spanish.
And
it was really different. They they use to they. The tools are different, no? They use Madonnas and holy and different elements.
And in Samarkand, in Silk Road,
you
can explain too that shamanism is mixed with Islam.
With
Sufis.
Sufis and shamanism. Then we have three examples. Very important.
Yeah,
we come back yesterday from Samarkand.
Very interesting.
Very nice.
Yes.
Yeah.
Working with Sufis.
With Sufis and shaman Sufism.
Interesting. And for the people, for the experience, do you can say that this context or this culture is more helpful for this and that than this culture, or is it? Would you say? It's if someone has an issue he wants to work on, it it doesn't depend on in which direction he's going to travel with you. Mm-hmm. Can you say something about this? Very difficult question, I know.
Yes, difficult. In all the cultures, you have healthy experience.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot say if you have a health problem, let's go to Baikal, or let's go to Mexico, or let's go to Samarkand, or to Silk Road. But we are just investigating, and maybe in a few years we could focus more, and it depends of the problem that you have, maybe let's go to Baikal, or let's go to Samarkand, or to Karakalpakstan. Maybe, but both.
Mexico, we know very well, and very,
better.
Better than the others. Because first, because language.
Language, it's always a problem.
And we know we can talk, and we work for 25 years, and we know very, very, very deeply the way of work of shamans, and they have tools very interesting too, to go over the
consciousness, to open or to enlarge
the consciousness.
Okay.
Enlarge the consciousness.
Expand the consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
You also did the training with Stanislav Grof in holotropic breathwork. Can you maybe say in a few sentences if this is or how this is also getting into this rituals or journeys? If this is you said before, it is an important aspect for you, your life, your work.
Mm-hmm.
Can you maybe say how it affects your journeys there?
Mm-hmm. Stanislav Grof, he told to us, I asked him 5 years ago, Stan, what do you think to going to the desert of Karakalpakstan, to Ayazkala, it's an ancient fortress, and to have the experience in holotropic work there?
Yeah.
And he told me, do you think that it's a good energetic place? And I say to him, I have been twice, and for me it's a good energetic place.
Mm-hmm.
Then the experience will be good one.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with you to go there.
Mm-hmm.
And it has been a successful experience, successful
mm-hmm.
journey
mm-hmm.
with more than 30 people
mm-hmm.
in yurts,
inside
the yurt, and having
mm-hmm.
with music, and hearing voices from the ancient Sufis.
Okay.
Oh, amazing.
Okay.
Amazing.
Yeah. Interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If it's a good place for you, it will.
Yeah.
But
very,
also
very
in
good.
Mexico, we had very good experience in
mm-hmm.
Mazateca
mm-hmm.
Mountains. Mazateca.
Mijes.
Yes.
Different
tribes.
Indigenous communities.
Yeah. Maybe you can say one more core sentence for people which haven't done yet such a journey, maybe also haven't experienced this transpersonal field even yet. Maybe you can say one or two sentences to the people, what could be the benefit or the treasure you find when you are when you go on this way of the transpersonal stuff, or when you do such a travel to the shamans, maybe you can.
It's a big transformation. It's before and after.
A big transformation.
It's a big transformation.
Can you say in which fields?
In the spiritual field.
Yeah.
It's the opportunity of to contact not only the human being of the place, each place.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's the opportunity to contact the spiritual way, the planet, the place, from the place.
And you mean the consciousness in general?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And how would you say it?
It's a full experience of love.
Mm-hmm. Ah.
full experience of love and unconditional love.
Unconditional love.
So we have to know the way to live in that, to know that experience and to become more open to one and another and to offer hacks to all our humanity.
Yeah, they're very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. This is a good word at the end, because I think a lot of shamans said it also to me, that shamanism is the training of love and the training of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Very good word at the end. Thank you very much.
Thank you to you.
Yeah.
George.
Okay.
You
and
George.
I wish you good journeys in the future.
Thank you.
And yeah, maybe there will be a journey together somehow,
mm-hmm.
somewhere. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye, of course. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Bye bye, everyone.
Uh-huh.
If you like it, you can push the like button downwards. And yeah, you can send the video to someone else. And I wish you all a good time. Bye bye. Jörg Fuhrmann, freiraum-Institut in Barcelona.
Bye bye.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Okay, perfect.